still have the burning desire to make up a new song that I like enough to go play for people and feel happy and not scared to death to sing it for them or embarrassed. And so when I get a group of songs like that, then I call it a record.
Can't see. If you're ever gonna fly without fear, you're gonna have to learn to love the atmosphere, and you gotta learn to use those wings that you can't see.
I had these songs that are a continuation of a record I made a few years ago called Home Away, and it was a lot of, almost all of the songs were about your work versus your passion. So I've made this album called Wings in a way that I had thought about for a long time. I wanted to put myself at ease, but also scrutinize what I was doing. And I think it worked out the best it's ever worked out for me in terms of having a focus. It's called The Day at the Troubadour. It's kind of a little surreal story about life on the road and being a performer. It says, it has a verse about Jesus because, you know, Jesus was a performer. You know, he did the Sermon on the Mount was a big hit. You know, people are still talking about it.
Of the Troubadour.
This new record started with home recordings of my vocal and my guitar. And then I took it to David Henry's place. The drummer, Paul Griffith, and the bass player, Tim Marks, are these great musicians who play on great records and have played with people much better than me, like John Prine, and much more successful than me, like Taylor Swift. So I've got this wide swath of people that these guys have worked with. It's been a few days where I could just sit there and listen to a vocal take that I was comfortable with and a performance on the guitar that I was comfortable with, and the rhythm section just played to what I did. There was no question, it was, this is how I did it, play to me. And we had a great time, and I got to sit back and listen without self-consciousness.
It ain't cool to talk about people when they're not around.
This is a song I wrote with Todd Snyder. So we decided to try to write this simple song that just had one little theme. And the theme was, it ain't cool to talk about people when they're not around. And so it's like, don't gossip. So there was a question about producing records. I think the one I've done that got the most attention and sold the most records was probably Todd Snyder's East National Skyline. And I was just lucky that he asked me to produce it because he knew exactly what he wanted to do. And I was lucky to, you know, be the person that he asked.
Three angels looking over me. Three angels make me smile. Three angels shining bright to see. Three angels hot and sassy, meek and mild.
When you make a real personal album, you want to leave out, well, I wanted to try to leave out like the end jokes or you had to be there kind of situations and try to make it universal. Balancing something that's personal and universal is something that you can learn from great artists that you listen to, like listen to the Beatles, listen to the White Album, listen to Bob Dylan, Blood on the Tracks, and you'll get a lesson.
Rise and shine from the bed.
This is a song I wrote with Irene Kelly. I had been reading this Buddhist book by this Vietnamese monk named Thich Nhat Hanh. One of the things he says is that take a walk because we don't know why we're here. So because we don't know why we're here or how we really got put here on this planet, that every time you take a step on the earth is like a gift, and every breath you take is like a little miracle.
Tomorrow's just a mystery, so I believe I'll take a couple hundred miracles today.
Let Me Be Your Frame is one I made up with Sarah Kelly. wrote the song with her, and it just wouldn't get out of my head. And I sang it and recorded it, and I liked it, but I really wanted a female voice to sing with me on every word, and I got Dawn Kennard to do it. It really turned out cool.
My eyes are the painter. They paint in your name.
I've had songs recorded by Little Feat, Todd Snyder, Jack Ingram, Jimmy Buffett. A lot changes the first time somebody whose writing you admire records one of your songs. You feel validated. And then it's even better if you get paid. And that occasionally happens still in the music business. Big, Big Love. There's another one that I wrote with Jeff Finland. My buddy Jeff Finland lives in Colorado now. And he sent me typewritten lyrics. And I was so charmed by this packet I got in the mail, because you never get that anymore. You never get mail. You never get letters. And nobody ever writes their lyrics. People just email you some stuff. You take for granted when you live in Nashville that, you know, you can just call a musician that played on like a Dylan record, or played on a Stones record, or a Graham Parsons record, or whatever. And they'll come in and play on your record, because they're just working. But they're brilliant. If you're willing to dig around and look, and maybe not be in the mainstream of the music business that's in Nashville, you have an amazing group of people, to pool of talent to draw from. Another thing I did on this record was to get some of my favorite, not all my favorite woman singers. I wanted Julie Lee to sing on Three Angels. The next song is Can't Go Home, and I got Sarah Siskin. I had Dawn Kennard sing on a song, and then my friends Marna Taylor and Lisa Oliver Gray sang. And then the great Jonelle Mosser, who's pretty well known throughout music. She was in a band with Don Was and Ringo Starr for a while. So there you go. I've got somebody who played with Ringo on my record. So this record this is 7 years later from Home Away, and I'm still home and I'm still away. New record's called Wings. I'm real excited about it. It's coming out February 23rd, 2010. So see you out there on tour somewhere. Thanks for paying attention.
Take a little taste of freedom high up in a cloudland kingdom. Take a little trip on the wings you can't see.